Welcome to today's service of Holy Communion from St. James Fuerteventura. My name is Yvonne and I will be leading today's service. Wherever you are watching from in the world, we hope that today that you can spend some time meeting with our risen Lord. All the words that you need are shown on the screen, my words in orange and your words in blue. And you may wish to have some bread and wine or an alternative to share alongside us later in the service. Today, Bob will bring us his thoughts on the topics of the benefits of love in the service later. So let's spend a moment of silence, preparing ourselves to listen to the music, the words, and hear everything that the Lord is sharing with us today.
We will join to give thanks and sing gladly. We will join to break bread and share wine. And the peace that we pass to each other will be more than a casual sign. So let's make with each other a promise that when all we've come through is behind, we will share what we missed and find meaning in the things that once troubled our mind. Until then, may we always discover faith and love to determine our way. That's our hope and God's will and our calling for our lives and for every new day.
The Lord is here.
His spirit is with us.
Loving Lord, open our hearts to your presence. Open our ears to your voice. Open our eyes to see your kingdom here in this place. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let love be genuine. Never pay back evil for evil. As far as it lies with you, live at peace with everyone. The peace of the Lord be always with you,
and also with you.
Let's sing together our first hymn, Tell Out My Soul, The Greatness of the Lord.
Thank you.
So now we have an opportunity to seek humility and confess that we may have thought, said, or done some things in the last week that have upset God, our friends and family, or others that we have met recently. We say together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. Thank you that in your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, you have forgiven all that is past. Grant that we may evermore remain in him, and he in us, to the glory of your name. Amen. Jesus gave his life for us on the cross, so that we can be forgiven. And to all who are truly sorry and believe and trust in him, Jesus says, your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more. Amen. Thanks be to God. And we say together our profession of faith. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess together the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, who made all things? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed the world? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God? I believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our reading today is from John 15, verses 9 to 17, and is read to us by Sheila Vine from El Cotillo. And then Bob will speak to us on the benefits of love.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another.
This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
There was once a new minister who on his first Sunday preached an excellent sermon on love. The churchwarden was well impressed. It was humorous, it was packed with illustrations, it showed a real depth of theological understanding, and he looked forward to all that the minister was going to be sharing with them in the future. The next week, he was still impressed. But there was something strangely familiar about what was preached. He started taking notes. After 3 months, he realised that the minister had preached the same sermon every single week. In fact, he could virtually recite it word for word, so he decided to challenge the minister about it. Look, I know you're busy settling in, but do you realise that you've preached the same sermon every Sunday since you got here. I do, said the minister. And I've been watching the congregation carefully for any signs that the message has sunk in. And as soon as I see any signs that it's taken effect, I'll move on to the next topic. Now, Jesus kept coming back to the same topic time and time again. And if you really want to be nerdy about it, he says the word love 53 times in the New Testament. That's just more than once a week for a whole year. There are between 51 and 53 Sundays in a year, so Jesus has the whole year covered. Maybe we should preach on it every Sunday. Well, actually, we do. In one way or another, you see, love underpins everything that we do and say as Christians. Love is the motive and the basis behind every sermon. Love is the foundation on which our lives are built. Now, I'm sure you all know that. And I do see it underpinning so many things in your lives. But if Jesus thought it was necessary to keep reminding his disciples, then obviously we need to be reminded too. Love was the reason God created the world. Love was the reason that Jesus came into the world. Love is the challenge and the freedom that comes from the cross. And it was love which raised Jesus from the dead. And it is love by which God pours his Holy Spirit upon us. And in our reading, it was love which was the driving force and the focus of his farewell message to his disciples on the night before he died. You see, we could preach love until we're blue in the face, but it's the action of that love within us and through us which is the transforming feature. You see, love is a doing word. It sees through both our words and our actions. It guides our words in the way in which we speak them, in the warmth and the truthfulness of those words. And it propels us into action through our response to the needs of those around us. But the real impact of love is defined by what we mean by the word, and more importantly, what Jesus meant by it. As we've seen in recent weeks, Jesus used the version of love, which is agape love. Total self-giving and self-sacrificing love. Love which puts God and the needs of others over and above our own needs. Now, that's not to say that our own needs aren't important, but hopefully they're being met through the agape love of our brothers and sisters. It's that agape love that holds together the body of Christ. You see, if we're all looking out for one another's needs as they arise, it becomes the perfect support model. And it turns full circle. We look out for others and they look out for us. We all benefit. We all thrive. We all grow into Christ day by day. It's only when that love starts to fall apart that the body suffers. And St. Paul has a lot to say about that in his letters. Google it. Self-giving and self-sacrificing. You see, it's not just warm and fuzzy, although that's part of it too. It's agape love, not just filial love, that friendship version of love. But it's that too. It's agape love, not eros love, sexual love, although that's good in its right place as well. It's so much more than all these things put together, and if you want to understand it, you do what we usually do. You look to Jesus. Look what he had to say about it in our reading. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. And in the commandments, it all comes down to loving God and loving our neighbour, everyone else. Because when folk try to define who is worthy of that love, when people try to limit it to just the local church or community, Jesus expands it. He expands it to those who hate us, those who despise us, and those who are even vehemently opposed to us. And that kind of love takes some doing. It's immense. It's overwhelming. It's beyond what we're capable of. But God's got an answer to that too. He sends his Holy Spirit. His Spirit lives within us to empower us, to guide us, to support us, and to transform the way that we respond to others in his love. But it's not just hard work. Yes, it can be. But Jesus points us to the benefits of love through the words that he had to say. He speaks of us abiding in his love, along the lines that Judy shared with us last week, of us being part of the vine, sharing in God's provision for us, and everyone's contribution towards that, and the fruit that that produces in the world. You see, abiding reminds me of resting in God, being sustained by him, and that sense of, you know, when things are tough, he just holds us close. He hugs us through the hugs of others. Something that's been sorely missing physically during this last year. But we've learned to hug through the warmth of our eyes and the gentleness of our words. So it's not all bad. And then there's joy. So that your joy may be complete, said Jesus. Joy is an inner sense of happiness, of knowing that you are loved and that in Jesus you have a purpose in life, a mission, a deep sense of satisfaction and fulfillment. Yes, we can still be hurt. We can still be let down. We can be depressed even. But when we know that we are loved by Jesus and by the rest of his family and are in the place where he wants us to be, then there's a deep sense of hope and a knowledge that things will get better. And then we're friends of Jesus. God isn't some terrifying, judgmental figure anymore. But one who comes alongside us, someone we can confide in and who's with us through to the very end and beyond. He shares with us that deep and ever-deepening knowledge of who he is and what we can do with him. Not out of duty because we have to, but out of love because we want to. And we're chosen. Chosen by him, appointed by him. We're not left on the sidelines because others don't value us, but God puts us on his front line because he created us, he gifted us, and he knows what we're capable of in him. All that is incredible stuff. The abiding, the joy, the friendship, held together by love and knowing that he has chosen me. He's chosen you. And we will make an impact in the world. There will be fruit. Fruit that changes the lives of others. We might not be heroes or celebrities or have our names written in the history books, but together in his love, through his love, in the power of that love, we will have made a difference. and our names will be written in his book. And that's more than enough for me. Amen.
We'll now sing together the song, Bind Us Together. Prayers are brought to us today by Derek Brough from El Cotillo.
Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for your love towards us. We thank you that your love is constant and does not change even when we fall short or wander away from you. We thank you that you loved us so much that you sent Jesus to bring us into a relationship with you. We thank you that Jesus is the Good Shepherd who gave his life for the sheep. We cannot comprehend the enormity of your love, but we are so grateful that we are your children and live daily under the banner of your love. Now let's just take a moment to thank God for his love for us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Faithful God, your Son Jesus Christ gave us a new commandment of love for each other, and so we ask you to teach us to love you in our neighbours, that by serving them we might serve you also. Just take a moment to name your neighbours and bring them to God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are the body of Christ, your church. We are diverse and different in so many ways, but we are glad that you love and welcome us all into your church. May we aspire to love, care, and nurture each other, that we may build each other up. Give us all a gentle and forgiving spirit, that we may be quick to forgive and slow to judge. Help us to show your love in our church. Just take a moment to thank God for your church and its community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mighty God, we pray for your church which day by day gathers to praise you and to hear your holy word. We pray for our Christian sisters and brothers worshipping you around the world, in small churches, great cathedrals, and on the internet. Give us here in our chaplaincy a sense of expectation as we come, and inspiration as we go. Bless our chaplains and those who lead us, those who preach and teach, to inspire us with the message of your salvation. Let's just take a moment to thank God for our chaplains and our leaders. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, the world so often seems to be a violent and fearful place. Give us the strength to love our enemies and to pray for those who by violence and acts of terrorism distort and demonize your wonderful creation. We bring to you the war-torn parts of the world and those places where power and authority are misused and abused. We pray that you will bring peace and restoration. Just take a moment to bring to God the places that have been on your heart. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father God, may our closeness to family and friends make us never exclusive, shutting others out, but always inclusive and welcoming others. Encourage us in outgoing hospitality and keep us from becoming possessive with those we love. We pray for those who are feeling lonely and isolated or estranged from family and friends. Will you bring them comfort and people across their path to help and encourage them? Just take a moment to lift to God any people that you might know. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, help us all to be part of the healing ministry of your church. Encourage us to constantly pray for those we know who are suffering in body, mind and spirit, or from coronavirus. Deepen our love for our friends and neighbours, especially those who are weak. Help to console the sorrowful and give hope to the dying. Just take a moment to lift to God those people who are known to you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful God, your love reaches beyond the grave. At the end of our days on earth, be with us and with those we love and with those whom we have loved and have gone before us. We pray now for those who have recently died. Give to the departed perfect joy of your eternal love, and to those bereaved by their passing, the consolation of your perfect love. Just lift to God any that you know who have been recently bereaved. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Holy God, send us out in the world today, mindful that as witnesses and servants, we should make you known in every place we visit and bear witness to the gospel with acts of faith, hope, and love.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. and we say together the prayer that Jesus taught us, praying the version on the screen or the version that you know best or in your own language. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As part of the offering of yourself to God, you may wish to send a donation for the work of the chaplaincy across Fuerteventura. Some of what we receive is given to support the Spanish Association Against Cancer here on the island, and some for Tear Fund for international relief and development work. Details for any donations are found on our website. Now let's sing together this wonderful version of the love song of the Welsh Revival. And afterwards, Judy will celebrate Holy Communion with us. Let us sing, "Here is love vast as the ocean."
We give thanks in the Eucharistic prayer. The Lord is here.
His spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love, you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ you shared our life, that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, he, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ, our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in the one bread. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. All are welcome at Christ's table. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Christ is formed in me.
And we give thanks together. Almighty God,
we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Our notices are all found on our website, www.fuertechurch.org, and we'll shortly be starting a video discussion course as part of the Church of England Living in Love and Faith initiative. It's designed to help us reflect on life as a Christian alongside different interpretations of relationships and gender in the current age. And we hope as many people as possible will be able to join in. So please let Bob know if you can attend. We're continuing to support the mission here on the island, and you can still drop off bags of foods and toiletries at Casa Bob, at church on a Sunday evening, or request a pickup. And our Sunday services are now in person in church as well as online, but keep an eye out because this may change as levels on the islands change. And our midweek in-person fellowship groups in Corralejo, El Cotillo and Caleta de Fusti will be meeting this next week and all are welcome. But please consult the website calendar and the social media regularly for updates on all our services and meetings. And now we sing together the song, The Blessing.
Amen. Amen. Manna rained down from heaven. This isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you. Children, his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, he is for you.
He is for us.
He is for you. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you.
go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.